Now, I would like to invite Miriam de Blecco. You will see her now, or can you see her, Martin? I think you can. And would like to invite her a couple of months ago in the Netherlands. Miriam is also in the Netherlands. She's from Baker McKenzie. She received from us the first Labour Right Index, a pile of a book, a big book, which we just printed and brought her in the night before another lockdown. It was that night still it was possible to meet each other. So Miriam, I think even you have it now in front of you, isn't it? Then so great. Yes, so then
yeah, you can't see it, but
it's
yeah,
huge.
There it is.
Yeah.
Yes.
And so thanks a lot. I welcome you to take the floor for a while to present your story.
Yes.
Welcome.
Hello all. Thank you very much for having me, first of all. And So Claudia asked me to make a picture. That's what I will do now, because she says I want to put it on Instagram. I am on Instagram, but so therefore I make a picture to just show everyone what this wage indicator can do. But let me start by saying that as Pauline said, I had the honor to receive the first copy of the Labour Rights Index, which is indeed a thick book. And I got that from Pauline from the Wage Indicator Foundation. And I would like to congratulate everyone who contributed to this beautiful book. And the World Wide Index is a groundbreaking new open source. And that gives important information on employment rights. It's freely available to everyone. And I think that's really important. Everyone has touched upon it. And open access to objective academic information on, for example, minimum wages is the first step, in my view, to a more equitable world. Labor markets worldwide have been severely impacted by the terrible COVID-19 pandemic. There's no question that the pandemic has changed our future of work for everyone in the world, almost. From an increased focus on health and safety to transitioning to permanent or indefinite remote work or preparing for business transformation, companies are facing critical business challenges in regard to their most important asset, which is their people. What we know for certain is that our world will be more unequal than it would have been without the virus. While some have access to sick leave and health services and continue to receive a salary, others, normally those at the bottom of the income distribution, who have no access to social protection, face catastrophic consequences. The Labour Rights Index can help to address the protection of labour rights for all workers, irrespective of employment or contract status or sectors of employment. Again, I share Wage Indicator Foundation's view that open access to objective labor information is the first step to a more equitable world. And therefore, I highly recommend this index. And I'm happy for all the people who helped contribute to the index. I would like to touch upon what Catalina Pasier said. And I Googled her, and Kathleen, I really, really liked one of your sayings, and maybe you forgot about it, but I wanna use it, not steal it, but I wanna use it as your open source. And that is, I'm not against men, but I'm pro women. So, because we're not there that women have equal rights to their male competitors. I shared a few that this is very important to also bring that to light. So thank you, and thank you all of you who contributed to this webinar as well, and to the mission of more labor market transparency for the benefit of employers, employees, and workers worldwide by sharing and comparing information on wages, labor law, and careers. Thank you very much, and a big congratulations again.
Thanks a million. Thank you. And very good.